everybody. Welcome to your English lesson. My name is Steve Ford, and today I have a great lesson, a fantastic lesson to help you to learn English the best way possible. So let's go. Okay. Do you drive? Does anybody watching this video drive? I'm sure that a lot of you drive. Fatima is saying no. This is interesting because I have more and more students, especially the millennials, who prefer not to buy a car. They want to use that money another way. Uber. Yeah, do you drive? No, I have Uber. That's an answer that I get a lot. How many times, if you do drive, and this is for all the folks, if you do drive, how many times did you take your driver's test? A, once. B, twice. C, three or more times. Three or more times. So how many times did you take your driver's test if you took your driver's test? I'm curious to know because sometimes people need to take the test more than once, but it's not necessarily that person's fault. Sometimes in some countries, they make you take the test more than once because they want you to pay more money, or maybe they want you to buy your driver's license. Yeah, I'm sorry to say that, but I've heard that in some countries that happens. So I'll go back to the question. Now, if you fail the first few times, we have an expression in English. We say, better luck next time. Better luck next time. So, if you fail the first time, no problem. Learn from your mistakes and try better next time. Better luck next time. And you'll see that there's this red L here. You see that? I don't know if you have that in your country, but in Canada, when you're just learning to drive, you need to put this red L on the back of the car that you're driving. And it says that it's that you are a learner. Yes. Unfortunately, some people, other drivers, they make jokes. When they see that L, they make jokes and say, ah, loser. I never say that. I never said that. I never said that. I always try to respect the drivers who have L on the back of their car. Yeah. We have two sentences here. The first one is, I have failed few times in my life. And then I have failed a few times in my life. Oh, those two sentences are almost the same, but they're not. There's a little difference there. What's the difference? Well, look at this. Few times in my life means not many, rarely. And then a few times in my life means some. On some occasions, sometimes. Do you see the difference between few times and a few times? So I want to ask you the question. Have you failed few times in your life or have you failed a few times in your life? Or maybe you failed many times in your life at certain things. It happens. I had one student who contacted me. And she had told me that she had done the TOEFL test 13 times before contacting me. I've heard of some people that needed to do their driver's test 4 or 5 times. It's if at first you don't succeed, try again. And this is so true. So if you are not successful the first time, if you fail a few times or even many times, you don't succeed the first time, try again. Yeah. And I really believe that. What do you think? Yeah, I hope you believe that too. And I hope that I can give you some inspiration because, you know, People contact me all the time and they say, "Oh, I'm so tired of English. I want to give up. I want to stop. Oh, English is so difficult." And I say, "It's okay. It's okay. Just you can learn from your mistakes and you can keep going and things are going to get better. Don't give up. Don't give up." And don't give up. Give up, by the way, is a phrasal verb. It means don't stop. Yeah. That's the important thing. Don't give up. Don't stop. Keep going. I don't know if I'm going to succeed. Why should? No, just keep going. It's going to work. It's going to happen. So you can see that I can't becomes I can. Can you hear the difference in pronunciation between I can't with a T? Americans don't pronounce the T. They just, ew, I can't. I can't. And then I can. I can. It goes up. Yeah. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. This is my next question for you. This is my next question for you. I'm very curious to see your answers. I will speak English perfectly. A, in less than 1 year. B, in more than 1 year. C, in 2 to 3 years. D, in 5 years. E, I have no idea. I have no idea. What is your answer for that one? If for those of you who said in less than 1 year, well, there's no time like the present. There's no time like the present. Maybe you have that expression in your language. There's no time like the present. That means it's good to do it now. And we have a phrasal verb, don't put things off. Now, a lot of people don't know what put off means. Put things off. Don't put things off. And to put things off means to delay or procrastinate. So, for those of you who chose letter A, probably you're the kind of person that does not put things off. Some people, I will speak English perfectly, D, in 5 years, and we could say better late than never. In case you saw my English lesson from last Saturday, I use this expression, better late than never. Better late than never. And another way of saying that is slowly but surely. Slowly but surely. And what that means is that if you have a race, this is a very familiar race, the race between the hare and the tortoise, the rabbits and the turtle, I will reach the finish line slowly but surely. So that turtle, that tortoise, maybe you know the story. And he's going slowly, but he reaches the finish line. So that's another way of speaking English perfectly, doing something perfectly in general, is little by little, bit by bit, you reach your goal, you reach your objective. Which kind of person are you? Let me know in your comments. Slowly but surely. Okay. And then, okay, let's go to, I gotta read some comments. So, Anne 7x7 is saying, "Oh my gosh, I'm a turtle." Yes. "And it's okay to be a turtle." Yes. "You can come to the Turtles Club. There are many of us." Yes. "There are many of us turtles. Turtles unite." Yes. "No discrimination against turtles, please." Okay. So, okay. So that's turtle. And Patricia is also a turtle. You see, Anne, there's some other turtles out there in the world. Patricia is saying that she's a turtle too. I told you, turtles of the world unite. Many of you together, many turtles together make the turtle population strong. And to be successful, to speak English perfectly, keep going no matter what. Okay, so here is another question. What do you think contributes most to your own success? And I have A, keep going no matter what. B, go the extra distance. C, learn from failure. D, take risks. What do you think contributes to your success or has contributed in the past to some successes that you have had in your life? Ooh, deep question, Steve. Sometimes taking risks isn't such a bad idea because you can learn from your failures anyway. I guess it depends on what the risk is. Yeah, how dangerous is that risk? But what we're going to do now is I'm going to teach you some more expressions related to time. And these are some expressions that people use all the time. And the first one is this one here. I know the place where I live like the back of my hand. I know the place where I live like the back of my hand. So maybe in your languages, you say it a little differently. I know in my wife's language, they say like the palm of my hand. But in English, we would say, I know that place, or I know that person, or I know something like the back of my hand. To know something or someone very well. So my question for you is the following. Do you know the city where you live like the back of your hand? So I mean, if you go downtown in your city, do you know it like the back of your hand, or do you need to use Google Maps? To rely on is to depend on, to count on, to trust. Maybe you didn't know that one. Rely on. How many of your friends can you rely on? A, one or two. B, three to four. C, lots of friends. D, nobody. Think about it, because I know there are some people they don't trust anybody. Maybe they just trust their mother and father or brothers and sisters. So how many of your friends can you rely on? Okay, so Mateos is saying nobody. Wow. Nikolai is saying one or two. Dave King is saying lots of friends. Okay, Dave, you're lucky. And then the last one, and this is going to make sense, is come across. Come across is to find something by chance. Come across. I mentioned this in a lesson that I did outside here in Vancouver. So come across just means like you find something, you weren't looking for it. Oh, look at this. I found this by chance. What a coincidence. You come across something. Have you ever come across something which reminded you of someone from your past? Yes. A, yes, a picture. B, yes, a gift. C, yes, D, no, the past is the past. So this means sometimes maybe you find some old object, could be an old picture. Maybe you find some gift that you received that you got from somebody in the past, years ago. And when you find that object, you're transported in time and you are reminded of that person. Okay, everybody, so we had a lot of vocabulary here today. And for the vocabulary in the last part of this lesson, I'm going to do a second video, which you will see appear in this video right beside me here. And it's a song that I'm sure that a lot of you know, which uses a lot of this vocabulary. Bye for now, everybody.